Hey guys, this is Nirmal from NirmalTV.com, and today we'll do a detailed review of Kingston's Data Traveler Workspace. So this is a Microsoft certified Windows to Go device. So the key feature of this is that you can run a Windows 8 Enterprise version from this bootable USB drive. So Windows to Go is a feature which Microsoft announced with Windows 8. So this allows IT administrators to easily support Windows 8 from a bootable environment instead of setting it up on Windows 8 machines. So this allows you to just plug the USB to any PC and run Windows 8 Enterprise version from this USB drive without having to do any installation on the PC. So the Data Traveler from Kingston, the Data Traveler Workspace from Kingston is a Windows to Go device, which means you can run Windows 8 Enterprise version without having to install it. You have to just plug this device into a PC and run the Windows 8 from there. So this is pretty useful for IT administrators. So we'll have a quick look at the specs. So this is a USB 3.0 drive which incorporates SSD controller technology to produce a high performance low latency drive. So it's a factory configured as fixed drive, so it boots through USB 3.0, or it is also compatible with the USB 2.0 ports on any hardware that has been certified for use with either Windows 7 or Windows 8 operating systems. So this is a Windows to Go drive. So let's first have a look at the device. So the design is pretty good. It has this current one which we are reviewing is a 32 GB unit, and comes with Windows 8 Enterprise. You have a holder here to carry the USB drive, then you have the cap, this is the USB port to insert it to the PC. So very simple design, and nothing much on the design front except for the logo, as well as the storage size and the Kingston logo here. So rest all remains the same. So this is the USB 3.0 port, but it's backward compatible with the USB 2.0 as well. So what we'll do is we'll have a demo on how to use this Kingston and boot it on the Windows machine and run Windows 8 Enterprise version on your PC without having to install it. So this also comes in 64 GB as well as a 128 GB variant. So currently what we are reviewing is 32 GB variant. So we'll have a demo on how this works, and then we'll see the other features of this device. So let's now have a quick demo of this Kingston Data Traveler Workspace, so the 32 GB variant. So let's insert this into my desktop PC and then we'll see how it works. So right now this PC is shut down, so let's insert this into the PC. So I have inserted into the PC. Now let's switch it on. So you can see the USB is in action now. So before that, you need to make sure that the bootable drive is selected to this Kingston instead of the hard disk which you previously set on your desktop. So now whenever you insert this drive, you automatically select the boot from the USB drive. So right now it's booting. So the desktop is now booting back from the USB drive, the Kingston Data Traveler Workspace. So it will boot from there and open the Windows 8. So when you first using the Kingston Workspace, it will configure Windows the way you install it on your desktop. A few minutes it will take to configure the workspace. So once that is done, you can see the Windows desktop in the start menu in action. So next time when you boot in, this won't be available. You will directly go back to the administrator screen. So you can see this is administrator account. So this is the Windows 8.1 workstation. So this is not the Windows installed on my PC. It's from booting from
the workspace. So you can see this is the desktop. So if you open the file explorer, you can see the local hard disk. There's only one hard disk. This is a 29.4 GB free space available. A total space, and out of that 14 GB available. So you can see these are the files available. So the local hard disk on your PC will not be available at this time. So in case you need extra storage, you will have to use an external hard disk. So right now I have the Western Digital hard disk here that's inserted. That's what is shown up here. So you'll have only one drive, that is a C drive, which will take the data from the 32 GB available. So it's a 29.4 GB total space available. Out of that, 14 GB is what is available for user to install apps. So you can see here, Windows Store is not work here. So you can see this app can't open. Store cannot open with using the administrator account. So Store will not be available for Windows 8.1 users from Windows to go. But you can install all the desktop apps. Now let's see what happens if you accidentally remove this USB drive. So right now it's pinned, this is in working condition. So what if somebody accidentally removes this drive? So let's try that case. So I have just removed this drive. So you can see that the Windows is still working. It's not shut down. But what happens is there is no mouse control. It is in hand state, which means it is still trying to find the USB drive, the files, but it won't shut down. So Kingston 32GB has this protection for 60 seconds. What you need to do is put the USB drive back before 16 seconds. So it will not crash. It will keep the files intact. So I just put this back in. So you can see it keep the USB drive plugged in. Only remove after the PC has shut down completely. Otherwise Windows to go work, this might crash, you might lose data. So Kingston data traveler workspace has 60 seconds protection. This means even if you remove drive, you can use it back within 60 seconds and you won't lose anywhere. So overall, this Windows to go drive is pretty handy. You can work on Windows 8 without having to install Windows 8.1 on your desktop. This is pretty handy for administrators in work environment to try out Windows 8.1. So overall, this is pretty handy. You can get this Kingston workspace in case you want the Windows to go on a USB drive. So that's all, guys. Thanks for watching the video. In case you have any queries on Windows to go or the Kingston workspace, you drop a comment and we'll be glad to help you out. Thanks for watching the video, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for all the latest updates.